O God, we thank thee to give thanks for the life of our
Lord. Song, precious Lord, take my hand. So please take note where you are to come in and let the program flow as it is. The scripture reading. What I know of him is that he's a very proud individual. He likes to be in the know. He likes to know who is known. When we started our association, he was actively involved. He walked, he did the walks with us, as well as participated in the meetings. Here I saw the bird, I said, okay, I don't know how far. When still searching for Mr. Morgan, who will bring condolence on behalf of Harry Morgan, we are going to take Dr. Kim. Kim.
Today being Mother's Day, I want to recognize all the many wonderful mothers that are here in God's holy house. I, gentlemen, but I also come here to say goodbye to a very, very special friend. The world would have known that Buddy was a true friend to me. He was a true friend in all the meaning of what a true friend was, even unto the very end. Even unto the very end. On behalf of my family, I kept him here. Today, he would never have gone. But as he goes,
gone too soon, but God knows best. Today, as you gather to celebrate the love and the memories of our dear beloved Bunny, words cannot express how much his passing has affected us. If we only had time, only time. Bunny was a yardstick of quality, and as a result, excellence was expected. He had a very high standard for himself and the people he associated with, and this made him unpopular. But he was always committed to maintain standard of excellence. Because we know you were a man of principle and respect, and that I must say you took to your grave. We could not embellish in you that we are living in the millennium, and it's acceptable to call your senior by their first name. But as Granny would say, you cannot teach old dogs new tricks. Bunny was a whistler, and his favorite song was "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." He never missed the church harvest with his produce. Bunny always speak in parables for you to decode the story. He was not a man of many words, but his passwords are Mirati and awesome. Bunny was a good cook, especially his Indian dishes. I will personally miss his tripe and bean and bird dishes. I got one recipe from him, and the ingredients are 1, 2, 3, and it surely works. Cause you are gone too soon. Oh yes, one less ride for the law enforcement have to worry about, and the whole community lost their lifelong security guard. Bunny was a caring and thoughtful person in his own skin. Cause I will surely miss you. If I only had time to tell you the things I wanted to share with you. We wish you farewell in your journey to eternity. You will never be forgotten. A thousand words won't bring you back. I know because I tried. Neither will a thousand tears. I know because I cried. Rest in peace. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kurt, most know me as Kenny's son, for those who don't know who I am. I'm one of Bunny's many nephews. I feel like everybody's showing me up today, everybody knows what I'm gonna say. But when I think of Uncle Bunny, I think of my dad times 10. I think of the aggression, the punctilious tribute. I probably spent the least amount of time with him because I lived in farm, and I didn't get to frequent to Jamaica as much as I wish. The other day, my cousin Glenda was sharing a story with me where he said that Uncle Bunny was teasing him and he said that I was his favorite nephew. Now, I know I'm not his favorite nephew, but it was comforting to hear. That was the last thing I would have thought he would have said, and I thank you for that, cuz. One of my fondest memories of Uncle Bunny was when I came up for Auntie Dundun's funeral, and he put me in the driver's seat to drive up Birds Hill Road. I had a driver's license for probably 2 days. I just learned how to drive on the right side of the road, and now he wants me to drive on the left side of the road. He told me, I said, Uncle Bunny, suppose I drive on the wrong side and I turn and I drop in a ditch. He said, you're good, man, just take your time and drive. I did good, and I surprised myself. And that was my first time driving on the left side of the road. As I watched the slideshow that was playing, it reminded me of Uncle Bunny, that he was my alarm clock. Every morning, him and my dad would be on WhatsApp sharing voice notes. And the two of them don't know what they're doing. They're having an operator's problem, as my mom would say. And he's calling me, Kurt, Kurt, come here. And after trying to troubleshoot, he don't know if it's him, he don't know if it's Uncle Bunny, and Uncle Bunny cussing the same way. Uncle Bunny, you'll be missed, and I love you, and may you rest in peace.
I hope you have a restful and pain-free in the afterlife. So sleep in peace, Uncle Bunny, for me and my family. We love you. Bye.
My dad was indeed impressionable, intimidating to some, whether intentional or unintentional, as the Ras and the Gutty Dash. He was revered by family members and friends alike, and without question, he was loved. He's as enriched my life as I'm sure he has enriched most of those who had the privilege of becoming acquainted with him. So here is to the man, a friend, an uncle, a brother, a son, a dad, a granddad. My dad, Jerome Pershard Bailey, and as our respect boss, until we meet again. At this point, I would like to extend gratitude and appreciation for the impactful and instrumental role played in regards to my dad. So to Uncle Kenny, Mr. Gifford Bailey, or as I'd like to call him, Bud, and his wife, Aunt Marlene. To one of the most precious person I know, Aunt Dana. To Uncle Ricky, Uncle Danny. To Uncle Tony, Uncle Meddy, and to Ray for always being there. To Mr. Morgan, you have been a true friend up and beyond. To Olivette, to Uncle Carol, Auntie Jenny, Lachi, Mikey, and last but not least, by all means, my sister, Audrey, and Auntie, who has been running tirelessly from before, spearheading almost all things that from the beginning. Love you, kiddo. Day if you need me. In life, we've been bestowed the gift of choice. And in this moment, instead of choosing aspects of mourning, I choose to celebrate the memories I have of my dad. And I wish you guys to join me in celebrating him moving forward. Amen. To all, and as I respect.
October 2, 1948, and take it on April 3, 2022. During the time of his give it and take it, he has given a lot and taken part in a lot of the life of his children, friends, and family members. You know, Audrey laments the fact that she didn't get to tell him all was on her mind, but he will always remain in her heart. I remember one fond memory of Bonnie and Audrey. He said to her, "Audrey, I'll soon come." And she said, "Daddy, where are you going?" He said, "I'm going crazy. You're coming?" That's his style.
Yes.
Bonnie was not a normal person. Neither was he abnormal. He was beyond normality. He was outstanding. He was born to stand out. Therefore, his life reflects that. I've been coming to Brazil for quite a while now, and I've heard many stories from he, she, and the old lady. But one story that stands out that I hear everyone say, "Bonnie loves Audrey." Everywhere I go, "Bonnie loves Audrey." Bonnie dared to be different. He was not everyone's cup of tea. To some, he was too hot. To some, he was too cold. And some just couldn't even take a sip. But whoever he was, like I say, he was different. He waited for no one except for his daughter. As soon as she came, she saw him that Sunday morning, he passed on that Sunday night. When he chose not to run with wolves, because he has no intention of howling, but rather he chose to associate himself with eagles as he endeavored to soar to new heights. While his siblings emigrate, Bonnie stayed here, decided to say, "I'm on Bonnie." So he stayed in Brazil and make a difference. He make an indelible mark in the community as he showered his presence all around. We paraphrase the words from Frank Sinatra as it matches the life of Bonnie Bailey. And now the end is here. And so he faced that final curtain. His friends, he made it clear. He stated his case, of which he is certain. He lived a life that's full. He traveled each and every highway. And more, much more, he did it his way. Regrets, he had a few. But then again, too few to mention. He did what he had to do and saw it through without exemption. He planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more, he did it his way. Yes, there were times, he sure you knew, when he bit off more than he could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, he ate it up and spit it out. He faced it all, and he stood tall and did it his way. For what is man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has naught. Not to say the things that he truly feels, and not the words of someone who kneels. Let the record show he took all the blows and did it his way.
Rest in peace, Daddy. Rest in peace.
Not sure if the button is here. Okay.
Singing, heart and hope, love, and firstly, just on behalf of my family, that throughout time, and despite the fact that what he was here to do, I had the opportunity recently, and I must tell you, it was not a happy self, and I know that he wasn't comfortable in that state. Because it's not the body baby who you know in the past. And perhaps beyond this earthly being, this human form that we have, God knows why he is now in another place. So let me just use the opportunity to say firstly to the family members, I want to wish you condolences, sincere condolences, and let you know that we are here for you. For the community that Bonnie served, which surrounding space, what situation, but it is good family. We are a constituency that has a big, well-recognized stature of a mayor, and we must be able to come together. Come down, before that, there was another shooting, and a man was killed. People, my family, my friends, we have to understand that the life we are given is not a game. And I know the morning when you get up, go down on your knees. Don't feel your when you leave here today, there's somebody who is either beside you or let it go. Let it go out of your heart. It's a chance they want to see you. I said, put money in a pandemic, what you want me to do? I lose my work. I'm not missing my work. People want to see you. It's a chance that the curb wall wants you to. It's a chance. The people they want us, it's always about his community. That's why I'm here. That's why I'm here. He was about his people. He was the MP for Etisalat. And I'm telling you, let us leave here, respect to him, represent him by making that change. You know who I'm talking to. You know what I'm talking about. Decide whether you're going to leave the same. Over there, you will leave different. One love.
Okay, thank you, Minister Coronel Charles. We will continue to work with you, sir. All right, at this time, we will take.
Hello. The Henrys of New Zealand would like to extend their heartfelt condolences to the Bailey family of Burtill on the sad passing of my Uncle Buddy. I've been able to spend time with Uncle Buddy whilst I myself was growing up in Jamaica. At that time, Buddy and my dad, Ivan Henry, actually worked together at the Diamond Mineral Water Company in Kingston. And every day, we'd ride together with my dad's, at that time, very distinct orange Volkswagen Beetle. My endearing memory of Bunny was being on the Bailey House.
Chat board, so
So we always would talk and we'd stay very close together. And they were like, that's part of my heart, the whole day family. And it's amazing that Miss Pearlie, Miss Ivy said before she passed, she said, we can't believe it, you know. Then it's going from me to my marry you. So she was always joking about it. She said, you know what, my young man's one problem? Because you don't pay for much. And I'm like, because it come off strong. But the thing about it, I will never forget. And it was painful when I heard him pass and I couldn't see him. Because the last time I was here, I didn't have to have a challenge between me and Joy. I was there by myself. And he cooked bread for me and stuff. And he brought the food to me with some bird that he got in our kitchen. So it broke my heart to know.
1948, according to Google records, there were light showers on the island of Jamaica. The temperature on this day that Bertram and Ida Bailey were blessed with the birth of their firstborn, Jerome Bailey, affectionately called Bunny. There is something about firstborns. They generally get the most love, the most attention, the newest clothes, the newest toys, you name it. Firstborns are known to get the most privileges. Bunny was the only one of the seven children in the Bailey household who, throughout his life, gets the onions, if you imitate it.
Continuing, Bunny was blessed to grow up in Brazil, Canada, a strong Assembly Adventist territory. During his childhood, Assembly Adventist Church was the school, the church, and the community center for everyone. Bunny was among the young protocols for life from the Bible. He too had to memorize Bible verses. He had to know the books of the Bible. He had to read Jesus, Onward Christian Soldiers, and Precious Lord, Take My Hand. His favorite scripture passage was Psalms 91.
Bunny was blessed to get a job at Seventh Estate at a very young age. He was hired as an office messenger immediately after he completed his schooling at Morris Primary. It is believed that it was his loving Uncle Tanny, now deceased, who got the job for him. Bunny was not as fortunate as his younger brother Kenny to own a for Bunny to get to work at 7, he would walk the trail in front of their home, in the grass through the woods, and across the river every day. Later in the early 70s, one of his best friends, Ivan Henry, now deceased, was instrumental in getting him a job at Diamond Mineral Water Company in Spanish Monroe. He was a salesman and a distributor of soft drinks and diamond syrup all over the island. Bunny was a very diligent worker. He was dependable, very committed, and despite having to travel from Brazil to Kingston every day, he was always punctual for work.
Bunny was blessed with two loving children, Jermaine and Audrey. You may not have known or may not have read Psalms 127 verse 3, but those words that were penned so many years ago characterize the great blessing the children were to him. Behold, children are a heritage of the Lord. It was not surprising to anyone
of his nieces and nephews will tell you that he behaved as if he were their father more than a big brother or an uncle. He loved to give orders. At the same time, it was very evident that he even had their best interest at heart. He had strict routines, but they were his way of protecting and keeping them safe. Despite his strict routines, they gravitated toward the scene played out in his life.
Bunny was blessed with the opportunity to travel overseas. He traveled to Toronto, to New York, and to Miami during the 80s and the 90s. There were some things about Bunny that were no secret. He was very traditional. He was a disciplinarian. He demanded respect. And he was a no-nonsense guy. He also loved his birth.
There were a lot of good friends and a huge family around him. He was the son, the brother, the nephew who stayed at home, the host who would organize the gatherings. Whether it were family members coming home or friends just visiting, he was the person to do the running around, to get the house together. transportation, and most important, food already and waiting.
Bonnie was blessed to have certain social activities he enjoyed in life. Everyone knew of his love for playing dominoes and his love for hunting birds. As a lefty, his bird hunting partners were always amazed at his skills. He very rarely missed the target. It is believed that he received his domino training from his late father, Mas Bertrand. It was quite remarkable to watch and listen to father and son at the domino table, especially when they were on opposite sides. Bonnie enjoyed and carried out another legacy of his father. He would always bring it.
When he became ill, he had family members in the home who cared for him. He had friends who made sure he made it to his doctor's appointments. He had visitors at his bedside during his hospitalization, despite COVID-19 restrictions. In retrospect, one can look back and see how the faithful God of heaven took care of Bonnie throughout his life. It was certainly a joy to hear that during certain moments, Bonnie was
saying for the family anymore. Who will make those arrangements? Who will have fresh fruit of the season? Take watch and wait him. Bonnie may not be here on birthday anymore to call him out of his sleep on resurrection morning. The last question for all who are missing him today is, will you be there to greet Bonnie when he wakes up in the first resurrection? Rest in peace. Something for us to think about. May his soul rest in peace with his soul.
Good afternoon, Church.
Good afternoon.
Second scripture reading from the Word on life. Clear as crystal.
This man of God, minister of the gospel. And so we are grateful to God for his ministry, and God continue to use him. And today again, God will use him in a mighty way to proclaim the word of God. But before he comes, Brother Duane Royce, the next voice you will hear will be that of Pastor Claude Brown.
God forever. Thank you, Darian. That was a beautiful presentation. I want you to, at this time, have a special prayer for the mothers among us, because this is their special day and they are well deserving. However, in the interest of time, because all of you have been sitting for quite some time now, and I have no doubt that the Mother's Day dinner is getting cold. Mothers who are not present are yearning to aroma of the food that is prepared is tantalizing, and you are encouraged to go home. So let me get straight to the matter from which quite a handsome man he was before his burial. And I cannot help but to remark, whoever reaps our best gifts, there is little or no need to bring wreaths to the place of burial, because the dead cannot appreciate the wreaths. Give your wreaths to the living. When they can express their gratitude, they can smell the aroma of the wreaths. By the way, give me my wreaths now. They may not be flowers. A kind word is enough. A loving embrace, a handshake, a sympathizing expression. Those are my wreaths. I would like to share with the family and with all of us a word from the Word of God. And use verse 21 and just a lot. It says, bow your heads, Father in heaven, guide and let your spirit impress every heart here this afternoon. In this brief postmodern man of life, the reality of life, the purpose of life. For we must all understand his eyes and what his hands can handle. These for him are life's rare, real imperatives. And so for him life is material. Life centers around material things. His asset, his secular circle, the material things he draws to himself with the rake of avarice is constantly drawing to himself, amassing to himself, because for the average man, life has all to do with material things. But you know, my friends, as the Bible tells us in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15, Paul tells us that if it's in this life that we are most miserable. Life, therefore, with us empty and a venture to say hopeless and worthless, life only has value when Jesus Christ is the center of that life. And so, I remember many, many years ago as a youngster, I know this life has a far greater value, has far greater worth than the woman in the man's life. None of us have ever seen the world any as bad as it is today or as worst. When we look at it, to see what is happening in Northern Europe and in their departure, they leave the world worse than they found it. Because I have seen individuals who have come to this world and have found the world a terrible place, but they have made sterling contributions. And then they are better than they found it. We must give thought not only to the Matthew chapter 4 and verse 12, appear to meet thy God. And if Eva was available in this life, when she was about to die, individuals visited her. Because you know who it is, as Jamaicans, we go to people's bedside when they're dying, hoping to hear a word of consolation from them. Her word was, her testimony was, I'm going to go. But she said, my one concern when I go, who is going to look after my one peeling rooster? Who is going to look after the one fowl I have left? That was her concern, her fowl, her cock. I heard another story of another lady, not picking on the ladies. This is Mother's Day. But I heard of another lady who refused even to walk through the gate of a church, never mind entering through the doors to have a seat in the pew in the church. When she was encouraged to go to the church on a certain day, she obliged those who pleaded with her. But as she got to the gate, she was seen, rather than using the gate to get to the door of the church, she was seen walking around the churchyard. What are you looking for? The individual asked her. The service is in progress. It's time to go inside. She said, I'm looking to see if there is any space left in the churchyard, because I will never become the member of any church in which I cannot find a place of burial. Her concern was about, not the fact, as Amos said, prepare to meet thy God. Mourners, the question is yet unanswered. Is there a purpose to life? Is there a purpose to life? Philippians 1, the text says, to be to live is Christ, and to die is gain. No wonder the faithful patriots has such a testimony. Job, the faithful patriarch, when he had lost all materially, when he lost his flocks, when he lost his children, when he lost everything that was around him, and almost lost his wife, he was heard to say, naked I came into this world, and naked go I out. I know that my Redeemer is alive, and that he shall stand in the last day upon the earth. And though after my flesh worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh one day I'm going to see God. David, the king of Israel, he too had his testimony. He said, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I have no cause to be afraid. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they are my comfort. Morning ones, there is very little to comfort us in this world today. Very little outside of a knowledge of Jesus to comfort us, because things cannot comfort us. The things around us are barely a facade. They are not real oftentimes. and reminds me so much of my primary school days and my primary school reading book. When I read the story of a dog, and the story was titled The Dog and the Bone. This dog had a master. His master was a butcher. He would leave a choice bone for the dog, and the dog kept for him. And so the dog, he went and he collected his bone. When the dog looked down below the bridge, he saw a shadow. It was a shadow of himself. In the dark, the shadow beneath the bridge, reflected in the water, was a dog with a bone. And the bone looked larger than the one that the dog was carrying. He dropped the bone from his mouth, plunged into the river with the hope to catch the dog with a bigger bone. It attracts the bees and the birds and the insects. But alas, the evening comes. An area in those days, I will pay you a just day's wage. And the men consented and they went out and they labored. At 9 o'clock, the Bible says, Matthew chapter 20, at 9 o'clock, almost the time of the setting of the sun, he went out for the last time. He saw young men standing idle, and he said to them, go work in my vineyard. And the same way that I gave to those who went early is the same way that I will give to you. They consented and they went. I do not know very much about Bunny's early life. I know very little about his daybreak of life. The morning time of his life may be referred to. Just put your arms around your wives. Father in heaven, how privileged we are today to be alive. And from what we have understood, irrespective of what his former life was, from the testimony given, he was prepared. He made preparation to meet you in peace. Lord, you promised that everyone who is faithful will behold you. For in when the trump of the Lord shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise incorruptible, awakened in an incorruptible life, we cannot now pray for Jerome. His probation is closed. He hath no part with the living anymore. But Lord, those of us who are alive, and within earshot of my voice, we now must make preparation to meet Jerome, but above all to meet our God and his coming. Help us, Father, to look beyond the things of this life, attractive as they may be. Help us, Lord, to live a life that is consistent to your will. Be with the mourning bereaved family. They are sad, Father, because no longer will they hear the familiar voice of Bunny. No longer will he have a space at the table. No longer will he be able to prepare delicious meals. No longer will they hear his loving words of comfort. But, O Lord, your promises, if we are faithful, and if he was faithful, we shall meet in a better land, in better circumstances, so that in that day we will join the ransom throng. Bless our mothers today. Lord, it is a privilege that they have to be a mother, that they might continue and save Jesus Christ. We are particularly concerned about the mothers whose children are tending to go astray. Help the mothers to understand that God will be weary, Father, but may they continue to lift up their children to you. May they never condone wrong with their children. May they rebuke the wrongs where they see them. And may they consistently follow the admonition of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, where he ought to go, so that when he's old, he will not depart from. Make the children to be proud of their parents. Help them, Father, never to let down the standards that their parents and particularly their mothers have set for them. And, oh Lord, because of the mother's faithfulness, and the...
Hey, you may be seated at this time. I want to say thanks to Pastor Claude Brown for presenting the Word of God to us. At this time, I will invite Sister Donna Henry to come and give us the acknowledgement and thanks.
Funerals after funerals. I have been the coordinator for so many funerals, but this one has been so difficult. But after standing, sitting here today and just listening to everything that was said, I am feeling hopeful and I feel good about my brother Bonnie. So yes, it's a struggle. I want to say thanks to whomever the person is that circulated that video recording of his voice when he answered the question and he said, yes, yes, I am ready to go. That settled it in my mind that my brother will rise in the first resurrection. So despite the struggle, the hardship, the grief, Audrey, I know you have been grieving as we love, we talk the entire family. But as we struggle to cope with the loss of someone so close to us, it's just so nice to know that there are people all over, far and near, thinking about us. Every day the weight of our burden becomes a little lighter because of the support of all of you. Our pastors, our elders, our church communities here in Birdsville, my church back home, the Miami Temple Seventh Adventist Church, neighbors, family, friends, friends of friends. I was at a store, I guess a supermarket in Maypen, and some lady, Sister Angela, Sister Donna, Bonnie was my good friend. And I'm like, wow, really? She said, I would help him pay the bills. Thank you, Sister Angela. There she is waving. All those who traveled long distances to be here, special thanks to someone who will never, ever be able to repay for all his kindness and hard work. This is the one name that is mentioned in this vote of thanks, and I'll brace myself, whatever comes. But Mr. Aaron Morgan, family, thank you so much. You have been a godsend. Members of the Bird Hunters Club, the musicians, the audiovisual team, the graphics artists, House of Wills Funeral Home, the caterers, the tent rental people, all everyone who worked so well with us, I say thank you, thank you. Perhaps you sent a warm message or made a phone call. Perhaps you sent a floral arrangement or that lovely card. Perhaps you cooked a meal, and I heard there were lots of meals cooked over that work, over the 1 month. Every day, somebody was cooking, the chef knows who he is. Perhaps you prepared that meal, or you helped prepare the burial site, or did some cleaning. I'm sure lots of people noticed what happened at the house, the fresh paint that was put on. Perhaps you sent a cash gift.
Yeah. Thank you. Everyone, attention here. There will be no viewing at the graveside. We'll be doing the viewing right here. So after it is closed here, it will not be open again. Thank you.
No, I want them to be the victims. Come check me now.
Listen.
Thank you. The casket and exit on that side. So I'll move that from in the place. We're going to do it orderly.
William, look after daddy. It's all right.
I don't know any.
All the way road.
Yes, man, I road, man. I don't say good no more. Yes, I'm so close. I say good. Well, I road. Say good, man.
Who are the view camp? Who need a view?
I'm going to see China.
just come down straight.
Switch hands and. I got.
Better than just going to coconut tree.
Yeah, man. Follow me. Okay, now you're going to know. Turn and switch hands, everybody switch hands. Switch hands and turn that way. Okay, reverse and that thing's going, head going go first. Turn that way, Papa, turn that way. Turn that way. Turn some, turn that way. All right, follow me. Turn.
Watch
you're going in that way, you're going in now.
Watch this one, man.
There you go.
Okay. Come on, take your time.
Sorry,
find yourself on the side, you know.
Hey, what needs up? Hey, listen up.
Give me a
one down. Easy.
Keep on.
Go to the back. Easy. No, come now. Okay. Step down, man. Step down and come in.
Come in, man. Don't push here. Don't push inside it.
Inside going.
But halfway, that's it. Halfway.
In. In.
Tight in halfway.
No, don't rest.
You want the back and slide.
Little more.
Yes, that's good.
Put the spray on. All right.
Okay, where are the immediate family members? Immediate family members, stand right there, please.
You good? Okay.
Immediate family members, standing right here, please. Can you give the family members a free